name is Omelogo, Nnadi, and I am called the Children Natural. This is the Children Natural series. Let's talk snowplow parenting today. What is snowplow parenting? It is a system, a style of parenting in which the parent tries to micromanage the child. He makes an attempt to protect the child from adversities, from problems, from obstacles. There is always that effort to remove the obstacles and the challenges from the child's ways, to fix things. You know, like you're always micromanaging the child to ensure that the child doesn't face any failures, that the child doesn't go through any problems. Now, so many parents are going to wonder, am I a snowplow parent? So are you a snowplow parent? It's quite easy for us to snowplow parent without even knowing that we're doing that. So how do you do that? There are simple things. For instance, you find parents who always make the attempt to help their two-year-olds to buckle their shoes. You're managing it because you want to save time. What you rather do at that point is teach the child to buckle its shoes and allow it to try it over time. Do not make that attempt to always buckle the child's shoes because you want to save time and let's leave the hole. Another thing people easily do is they help children to complete their assignments. I mean, they bring homework from school and final pieces so much. And you find yourself trying to help the child to quickly complete it because the child needs to go to bed or the child needs to leave for school or something. And then what about coming down to our climb here in Africa and in Nigeria to be specific? You find parents who register their children in special centers, examination centers. I mean, why? What's so special about your child that your child needs for you to pay for a special center so that the child will go and write exams that other people have been writing and scoring good? And then you have parents who also help children to gain admission into the university. I'm not saying that you shouldn't do these things, but the thing is this: there is a tendency to find yourself trying to manage things that the child ought to be doing by itself. Things that would help the child to gain confidence, things that would help the child master problem-solving skills, gain control on its emotions, learn how to face the risks and challenges of life. And then because you want to save the child from failing, you jot in, you do it a bit today, and before you know it, you're doing it over and over and over again. There's so many simple things. How about trying to help your children copy notes? I mean, I once have a friend who told me that during the pandemic, for instance, that at the point when the schools began to send a lot of assignments via the internet here in Nigeria, I had a parent who told me that she had course to help her children to copy their notes because they sent a lot of notes over the internet and it was a lot. And then before the children were able to finish, there was next assignment to be done for the following day, and then she had to help them copy. At what point does it stop? You're going to help them copy these notes so that you can help them save time, so that they can be prepared to do the assignments for the following day, but at what point do you stop? That is how it starts. You start to micromanage them. And before you know it, you don't even give them the opportunity to gain the attributes that will help them to face life square on. So what are the risks of snowplow parenting? What is the risk when you snowplow parent your child? One of the major risks is this: your child loses the ability to handle risks. Your child loses the ability to solve problems. Your child is used to having problems being solved for it. And then when it faces these problems, it is confused. That is one of the major risks of snowplow parenting. Now, before I take you on to the so many other risks of snowplow parenting, let's go on a quick commercial break. When we return, I will continue. This is still the Children Natural Show.
Little Crystal's Cradle LCC, a home crack set in the city centre of the Federal Capital Territory, offers daily drop-in for toddlers and preschoolers and a second home option for your little ones. With reliable care that pays attention to each child's peculiar developmental needs and pace, We nurture your children deliberately towards a full childhood. You never have to worry if your little crystals are doing okay, because at LCC, it's truly a home away from home. Open 5 days every week from 7:30 a.m. to 7 p.m. We accept your babies from 3 months. At Little Crystals Cradle, we think children, we breathe for children, and we live for children. Looking for that trusted eagle-eyed care for your little ones? Then call us on 0818-275-5951. LCC, deliberate steps to lofty heights.
This is still the Children Nurture Series. Welcome back. So previously I was telling you about the risks of snowplow parenting. And I already told you the major risk. Your child loses the ability to solve problems when it faces problems he encounters with friends, because he's used to having problems solved for him or her, and then he gets confused. A child loses esteem. So he begins to have low self-esteem because he sees other people who are able to handle situations and he cannot. A child begins to lack the ability to handle frustrations and challenges in life. The child becomes confused. He becomes planless because originally he's had people plan things for it, and then he finds himself in a situation whereby he has to do that and he loses his ability to plan. One of the other things you find a child doing is he always tends to seek approval or consent from people before acting. He's always second guessing. He's used to having people tell him what to do or tell her what to do, prod it or guide it, and so he needs to seek approval over time for everything he needs to do. He becomes timid, sometimes shy. He becomes unable to solve life's critical problems. A child who has been micromanaged gets to a time when he begins to second guess himself. He lacks that ability to persevere. He faces challenges and he finds himself not able to try beyond the first time. He easily gives up. A micromanaged child, a child who has suffered a snowplow parenting, is unable to learn things easily because there is no push, there is no probing, there is no internal encouragement from him. He always has a micromanaging from above, and so he begins to feel so dependent. And where there is nobody to depend on, the child encounters a flaw. He is flawed by as little as minor challenges that really you have been able to handle. Now, what are ways that you can change the style of snowplow parenting? How do you change the style? What do you do? Instead of telling a child what to do, instead of telling this child, try to encourage it by asking questions. Do not tell it what to do. Ask it. So, okay, we're going to have to construct a box for your assignment for school. What are the things you think we can use? What are the things you think we need to get this done? Are there some resources that come to mind? This is a way to try to prod it into taking an initiative. Remember, one of the risks of snowplow parenting is this: the child lacks absolute initiative. He is hardly able to decide to take on a challenge or a task all by himself. He always feels the need to have somebody lead him. He doesn't have leadership skills. He doesn't have initiative. So, in fixing it, in changing the style of snowplow parenting, what you need to do is try to encourage the child to, by himself, seek how to solve problems that face it. You're going to be there. Remember, it's not automatic. This child is used to use micromanaging him. So a way to change that is you need to encourage the child to think. Encourage it to reason. So, you need to incite reasoning. Ask him questions at every point. Make him put his reasoning to action. Activate it and let him continue to think and wonder how these issues can be help the child who has been snowplow prevented over time. And you need to constantly prod, gently prod. Do you think we should? Why don't you do this? Work with the children, all right? At every point, work with them. Okay, so they have a task that they are going to accomplish. Don't tell them, go and do this. Oh, no. Sit with them. You need to do this. Okay, how do you think we should go about it? Should we start from here or start from there? All right? Always make an attempt to show them that, yes, I've always done these things for you, but now there is need to change it. And now we can do this together. So why don't we start this way? Okay, so these are some of the ways that you can manage a child and change the style of parenting. And there is one. But before we get to all that, let's go on a commercial break and we will be back. Till the Children Nurturer series. Stay tuned.
Looking forward to 2021. And I can't help but think about what I can do, what I can add to the industry. I know, of course, the film industry, because there are so many young people out there that want to be filmmakers, but they don't know how to be filmmakers. So I'll be making a series of videos of step by step you can take to becoming a filmmaker. So I will be posting the first one on the 4th of January. The next one will definitely be the next Monday. Not everyone is opportune to be in a film school. Not everyone has the funding or support to be in a film school. So if you're out there, it will be a good time. Subscribe to the channel, click the notification button so that you don't miss out. I'll see you on the other side of 2021.
You're welcome back to the Children Nurture series, and we're still talking snowplow parenting. Just a moment ago, I was telling you about the ways, things that you can do to change this style of parenting if you've been on it for so long, and I'm giving you a rundown already. Now, I need to tell you that to change this, do not be tempted to save time. Do not be tempted to save yourself from the stress of talking. If you need to change this, you need to be deliberate about it and pay attention to those simple things that usually you would do for the child that seem so insignificant, but which ends up being micromanaging the child. And so it takes time and it takes loads of patience. It takes time for you to look at the child trying to fix these things and patiently look at him without being pushed to go and help. It takes a lot of patience to watch this child fail and fail and fail all over again and feel frustrated in that failure and look at you and expect you to help, and all you do is to a gentle prodding and encourage him to try just one more time, and after the try, encourage him to try one more extra time. That is how you fix it. If you're tempted to save them stress now, you will keep on micromanaging them. But why don't you spend the time now, stress now, and then secure their future? Do you think that is a good idea? Yes, you can ask me and say yes. There are ways that you can stop snowplow parenting and empower your child to develop life skills, problem-solving skills, confidence, high self-esteem, sure-footedness, courage, ability to face any challenges that come his way, because you have empowered him right from the get-go. This is something that snowplow parenting prevents you from doing, prevents a child from being an anti-child. Now, that's the end of today's topic. I hope that you gained a couple of things from it, and then this is going to help you to parent better. If you need help with deactivating this style of parenting, if you need a guide to help you through plans and routines that are peculiar to your child and you may reach out to the Children Nurturer. I will be glad to help. Just send an email to thechildrennaturer@gmail.com. The address is on your screen. Send an email and I will get back to you. My name is Omelogo.